The Sandman Season 1 shows us a world of goth immortals, talking pumpkins, and a man with teeth for eyes. Bridgerton it is not. Ensnared in its dreamy logic, you may have been left with a few questions.
I'm sorry, I don't understand any of this.
So let us turn any restless sleep into satisfied slumber with The Sandman's ending explained. Spoilers obviously abound, so get the series watched first. By the end of the show, Dream has dealt with the escapees from his dream kingdom. The shape-shifting Galt is reborn anew. The living field Fiddler's Green has given up his life as Stephen Fry, and the Corinthians' killing spree ends in literal meltdown. But more complicated is the matter of the Dream Vortex.
There is a Dream Vortex. The first for a long time.
Dream spends 5 episodes reclaiming his helm, Ruby, and Sand Pouch, only for this fresh problem to arise. And if you're wondering what a Dream Vortex actually is, you're not alone.
So, what is a Dream Vortex?
What's a Dream Vortex?
And what's the point of a vortex?
What is it for? What does it do?
Why do we even exist?
Few things in The Sandman are defined in basic black and white, but the general gist is that a Dream Vortex is a mortal born with the ability to travel through other people's dreams. In this case, Rose Walker, who gets to potter about the nocturnal visions swirling in Hal's guesthouse, and later, the collective horror show at the serial killer convention. Problem is, this weakens the walls between dreams, which in turn threatens the stability of the dreaming itself.
You were right. The vortex was responsible for the damage to our realm.
It's Dream's job to find and kill a dream vortex whenever one arrives every 1,000 years. But in this case, it's not as simple as that. You see, Rose Walker was not intended to be the Vortex. The role originally belonged to her great-grandmother, Unity Kincaid. But before Unity could start smashing dreams together, she slipped into an endless sleep as a little girl. Yes, she was one of the victims of the sleepy sickness that struck when Roderick Burgess imprisoned Dream back in 1916. This next bit is kinda creepy. While in her endless slumber, Unity dreamed a whole other life, including meeting a man with golden eyes and him fathering a child with her. Only that dream baby manifested in the real world. Unity became pregnant in her coma and gave birth to the child who would become Rose Walker's grandmother.
I'm your great-grandmother, Rose.
Not as unusual as it first sounds. Lyta also becomes pregnant with a dream baby after sleeping with her dead husband in his very swish imaginary house. Anyway, back to Rose. With Dream escaping captivity in the modern day, the job of Dream Vortex is inherited by her great-granddaughter, Rose Walker, setting her on a collision course with our brooding hero.
It is not what you did, it is what you are.
As mentioned, a Dream Vortex is traditionally killed by Dream, the only time one of the Endless, more on them in a second, can directly interfere with the lives of mortals. So, after reducing the Corinthian to an adorable mantelpiece ornament, Dream takes Rose to Fiddler's Green to finish his unpleasant task.
I do not wish to take your life, but we all have responsibilities and this is one of mine.
Thankfully, her death is stopped at the last minute by Unity and Lucienne. Rose's great-grandmother had visited the Dreaming's library, where every book ever written can be found, and read her own life story, discovering that she was once intended to be the Dream Vortex. She tells Rose to transfer the vortex power.
But how?
You're dreaming, darling. Anything is possible.
Rose saves herself by handing over the power, represented by a glass heart, an object that is very important for understanding what is going on this entire season. The glass heart is the sigil of Desire, who, like Dream, is one of the Endless. 7 siblings who each rule a different realm, feeding into aspects of mankind's lives.
There are benefits to keeping one of the Endless close.
The Endless?
Did you think death was the only one in charge? The Reaper has family, you know? Desire, destiny, despair.
Each Endless has a gallery used to talk with the others. tastefully reflecting the personality of the sibling. Dreams has big, misunderstood teenage goth energy compared to Desire's gaudy PVC nightmare. More importantly, Desire's sigil within the gallery is a glass heart, the first clue that they played a role in the Dream Vortex problem. The second is Unity Kincaid recalling a man with golden eyes. Yes, it was Desire who fathered her child while she was in a coma. Desire's whole deal is built around bringing down Dream. We learn from Death that Dream and Desire have a long-held sibling rivalry.
I think Desire missed having their usual sparring partner across the dinner table.
That would be fine, but familial animosity has soured into something much more sinister.
Do you think these little games of ours will change him?
This is no game, my twin. Dream still behaves as if his realm is superior to ours. It's time that he learned that dreams are merely echoes of desire and despair.
By fathering a dream vortex, Desire was trying to trick Dream into killing a member of his own family. After all, Rose carries the blood of the Endless and is technically his great-niece. While we aren't told what happens if an Endless kills an Endless, we do know it wouldn't be good.
What did you truly intend? That I should spill family blood? With all that would entail?
This time, it almost worked.
We also learned that this isn't the first time Desire has moved against their brother. While scheming with their twin, Despair, Desire mentions two previous schemes.
Nada was a mistake. Roderick Burgess was a diversion.
Yes, Desire had a hand in Roderick's capturing of Dream, setting the whole story of the Sandman in motion. But more intriguing is the mention of Nada. This is the woman Dream sees in Hell, reminding him of a relationship that once almost ended in ruin.
It has been 10,000 years, Nada. Yes. I still love you. But I have not yet forgiven you.
This suggests that Desire has been plotting Dream's downfall for at least 10,000 years. And you thought your family had issues.
I will not give up hope.
While we're talking family feuds, Season 1 ends on something of a nervous truce. Dream threatens Desire, Despair, and an unseen sibling, Delirium, from moving against him, Death, and Destiny, another sibling we're yet to meet in the series.
Do you believe yourself strong enough to stand against me? Against Death? Against Destiny?
With the rough 3-on-3 split, there is a seventh sibling hinted at throughout the story, the absent Prodigal. Missing before Dream was imprisoned, they hadn't turned up in the intervening years.
Any word of the Prodigal?
No. Still missing.
And Desire and Despair are no wiser as to their location.
The Prodigal has returned.
What? Oh. Him. No, he's still missing.
For now, the Prodigal's frame in the Endless Gallery remains empty. In the comics, this AWOL sibling is Destruction, a tantalizing taste of potential future adventures.
Was I really that obvious?
Earlier in the season, Dream managed to best Lucifer in a battle of the wits, but also left Hell's leader with a bitter taste of embarrassment.
One day, Morpheus, we shall destroy you.
It seems this reckoning is fast approaching. The Lucifer we see at the end of the show is having a permanent pajama day and wallowing in the shame of having lost to Dream, until she is beseeched by Azazel, one of the Lords of Hell, to invade the Dreaming.
Since none of us may leave Hell, we may as well expand its borders until Hell is all there is.
And so Lucifer puts in motion a plan. Readers of the comic will know what this entails, but we wouldn't spoil that here. Needless to say, a creature as cunning as Lucifer Morningstar would never pursue something as base as a simple invasion, leaving us with this most intriguing threat.
Something that I have never done before. Something that will make God absolutely livid. And bring Morpheus to his knees.
Again, something for future stories to explore, perhaps. But for now, we hope this video has helped explain some of the twistier elements of this most twisted of tales. Why not share your thoughts on the Sandman in the comments and subscribe to Still Watching Netflix for more videos on your favorite Netflix films and shows.